15. I was left alone for weeks on end to look after myself. I was always hungry.
I was sexually abused at the age of 12.
14-year-old boy. My mother was a prostitute and would advertise that she could bring me was to watch.
8-year-old. I was sexually molested by my grandfather and later found out that he is also my father and he also molested my mother for years.
My mother burned my father in front of me and I watched him die and she went to prison for that.
My mother died, my father went on a trip and returned as a woman and forced me to call him mom. When I refused, he would hit me.
15. I was sodomized by a group of men and they made me do things to them which I don't want to do.
Take our hands and become part of our journey.
The children's home gave me hope.
I can become anything I can dream of.
I'm able to attend school now.
Now I am safe and feel secure.
Good day. My name is Prudence Ngoveni and I've lived in the children's home for the 5 amazing years. The children's home has always been a blessing to me. It has been always been something that I actually look up to and stuff. Basically, I've lived here because I was sexually abused by my uncle. And it was one of those moments in my life that I thought that this is where it ends, where my life is gonna end, and that's when I thought that this is it. But then I was brought to the children's home and it showed me a lot of things. Like it opened my eyes in a lot of ways. Like it brought some light in my life because it showed me that what I've went through is one of the difficult challenges that I've ever gone through, but it's not the worst that could ever happen, because a lot of kids have been through a lot. And I'm actually thankful that I ended up here. And I just want to say that to every kid that is in the children's home, I wish they could actually see that this is an opportunity and they could just make use of it like I did.
14-year-old boy. Me, my brothers and sisters were exposed to pornography, satanism, and sexual abuse for years. I am now embracing all the opportunities in life. I smile every day now.
I appreciate everything I have, because I had nothing. I now have a job and coping on my own. I can trust again, and I am whole again. I am married, I've brought my own home, and I have a beautiful child.
The reason I was in the children's home is because my family, I didn't really have a family. And my grandma was the only one who looked after me. And after a while, she couldn't look after me anymore because she didn't have any money left. And she wanted me to go to school. And we were struggling and we weren't really doing anything with our lives and everything.
I appreciate everything I have, because I had nothing.
I have now my own bed. I don't have to sleep under a tree anymore.
The children's home gave me hope.
Good day, my name is Danielle Nell. I was in the Jakaranda children's home during my formal education and schooling years. Currently I'm busy completing my PhD, a doctorate in public governance and policy management. I'm also a research advisor at the Sundance Centre for Public Management. I'm also very actively engaged in the community, in student development and academic development. My experience of the Jakaranda Children's Home was a life-enriching one, and I wouldn't have been able today to pay it forward and give back a little bit if it wasn't for the care and attention and support I received in the Jakaranda Children's Home.
The children's home taught me a lot of things. I mean, I've been in the children's home for a long time. I made new friends. They became my family. And the house mothers took care of me. Children's home took care of me. They gave me a bed to sleep in every night and food every day. And I'm actually blessed to have been in a children's home, because if it wasn't for a children's home, I would be on the streets or in jail or busy doing drugs.
We don't discriminate against race, gender or creed.
Regardless of our skin color, our beliefs, our religion, or where we come from, it has catered for all of us. It has showed us that color doesn't really matter. I have white kids that I left within my house, and I call them my sister. And they called them to me when they needed something. And that just showed me that it's one, we are one, we just as one. We just have to unite and work together and be as one. So I'm really, really happy that I could actually see that part of life. So anybody that wants to offer help, it doesn't matter where you come from, where you are going, do it from your heart, because it's going to make a difference in every kid's life. Black, white, colored, it's just going to make a difference.
My brother, sister and I lived on the street all of our lives. We had to survive by eating out of dustbins and slept under a tree. We could not go to school and had no one to protect us.
Learn from yesterday, live for today, hope for tomorrow.
You can make a difference in our lives. Get involved and help us. Food donations, money, volunteer your time, clothing donations, adopt a home. Visit us on jakarandachildren.co.za and luibotachildren.co.za.
Take our hands and become part of our journey.